Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Today, we are studying about how microorganisms have helped humankind in various aspects. For example, microorganisms help human beings in the production of antibiotics, that is, industrial production. Use of microorganisms for the production of biofertilizers, which are organic fertilizers. Use of microorganisms in the form of biopesticides. Rather than using chemical pesticides, we can use this biopesticides. Use of microorganisms for sewage treatment, that is wastewater treatment, which can help the municipality of our country. Last but not the least, use of microorganisms for the production of biogas, which is natural gas. So we see that how microorganisms have helped human beings in various aspects of life. For example, methane gas or biogas, which is produced, is far economical, far better to the environment as well as to human beings as compared to the normal LPG. On industrial scale, production of antibiotics like penicillin, rifampicin, chloramphenicol, all these broad spectrum antibiotics can be produced using microorganisms. Even enzymes like lipases, pectinases, proteases, streptokinases, all these enzymes which have various application, whether it is in juice industries, for example, when you eat a Tropicana ice cream or when you drink a Tropicana juice, it will have an enzyme called as pectinase, which is present inside the juice to give a better texture or flavor to the juice. Similarly, when you have a dirty cloth or a dirty laundry, to remove that stain or oil from that cloth, the enzyme that is used is lipases, and this enzyme is produced from microorganisms. Similarly, when the municipal corporation treats our waste, there are three stages that goes in the waste treatment: primary, secondary and tertiary. And during all the stages, various aerobic and anaerobic microorganisms are used, whether it is in sludge digestion or in BOD production. So let us see how microorganisms have helped mankind in various aspects. We were studying the use of microbes in human welfare. Microorganisms can be used for various aspects. The first one is microorganisms in household products. Production of household things like curd, idli require lactobacillus species, an organism or a bacteria that is naturally present inside a room, which is used for the production of this household products. The next one is microbes in sewage treatment. When I say sewage, it means wastewater treatment, or the same water which is treated by municipality, the wastewater that comes out of your house. Primary, secondary treatment of microbes use aerobic or anaerobic microorganism. When I say aerobic, it means the organisms which require oxygen, and when I say anaerobic, it means the organism which do not require oxygen. They can live or thrive on carbon dioxide. The next is microorganisms in production of biogas, or we called in normal language gobar gas. Methane gas or eco-friendly gas, or we all say gobar gas, is produced using methanogens. Yes, the normal eco-friendly good bacteria that is present in cow dung, which is used to make gobar gas in biogas plants in normal villages, which is cheap and easily available. The next use of microorganism is use of microbes in biofertilizers and biocontrol agent production. The example of this would be Azotobacter anabaena. Now, these are the microorganisms that live in symbiotic association. When I say symbiotic, it means give and take. The plant helps this microorganism by giving food, and in return, this plant is helped by the microorganism. These organisms live in symbiotic association with plants and act as a source of manure, which is compost, which is organic, or provide nutrients to the plant, which could be nitrogen or phosphorus depending upon the organism. I hope we all have understood the topic about how microorganisms have helped mankind in this part. Thank you.